might become saved if we don't.
Yes.
We don't want to be so narrow-minded, Lord, that we don't reach out to others, that they might become like us. We remember when we were saved.
Yes.
And so we come this morning asking that you just reach out and touch
us.
That come in the fullness of your word, Lord.
Yes.
And we just thank you this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Praise God.
Yes. It's good to be here this morning.
Amen. Yes.
I'm honored to be here this morning. And we thank God for the man of God who permitted us to be here.
Yes. Yes.
We know that he's ill, and we've kept him in our prayers.
Yes.
And we've kept our friends in our prayers.
Yes. Yes.
At all times.
Yes.
And it's just nice to be able to help out whenever you get a chance.
Yes. Yes.
You don't know when your chance is coming.
That's right. All right.
Amen. God's been good to us that we've been able to be available. We wouldn't be anywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were asked to be here last week and this week.
Yes. All right.
And you can't ask for better than that.
Amen.
If you would, I'd ask that you turn your Bibles, those who have Bibles, to the 6th chapter of Judges. We want to ask that you always bring a Bible in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
There's no need of coming in the house of the Lord unless you get ready to take some word back with
you.
You can't know what the preacher said is right or wrong if you're not reading along with him and you're just going to take his word for it.
Yes.
We're in the 6th chapter of Judges. We're going to begin with the 12th verse. It says, "And an angel of the Lord appeared unto him, and said unto him, The Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor.
Yes.
And Gideon said unto him, O my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befallen?
Yes.
Where be all this his miracles which our fathers told us? Saying, Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. And the Lord looked upon him and said, Go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianites. Have not I sent thee? And he said unto him, O my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel? Behold, my family is poor in Manasseh. And I am the least in my father's house. The Lord said unto him, Surely I will be with thee, and I shall smite the Midianites as one man. And he said unto him, If now I have found grace in thy sight, then show me with a sign that thou talkest with me. Depart not hence, I pray thee, until I come unto thee and bring forth my present. Set it before thee. He said, I will tarry until thou come again. And Gideon went in and made ready a kid and unleavened cakes and an ephah of flour and flesh. He put it in a glass basket. He put the broth in a pot and brought it out unto him under the oak and presented it. And the angel of God said unto him, Take the flesh and the unleavened cakes and lay them upon the rock, on this rock, and pour out the broth. And he did so. Then the angel of the Lord put forth the end of the staff that was in his hand and touched the flesh and the unleavened cakes. And there rose up fire out of the rock and consumed the flesh and unleavened cakes. Then the angel of the Lord departed out of his sight. When Gideon perceived that he was an angel of the Lord, Gideon said, Alas, O Lord God, for because I have seen an angel of the Lord, the Lord said unto him, Peace be unto thee. Fear not, thou shalt not die. Now, brought for a thing, how to identify a man of God. When you're trying to identify a man of God, you have problems, especially in our neighborhoods. Israelites God had taken them to that land.
Yes.
And then they had strayed away from God.
Yes.
They did things of evil. They sought other gods.
Yes.
Even while God was the one who brought them there,
right,
he was the one who brought them to a land of plenty, remember? He
yes.
was a man that he brought them to a land where they didn't have to grow anything.
That's right.
It was already grown before they got there.
Right.
They didn't even need rain. The dew was one that wet the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And things grew.
Yes.
So Israel had a land of honey. Israel had everything.
Right.
But they turned away from God. And sometimes we turn away from God.
Yes. All right. Yes.
We turn away from God with our men. We need our men. Our men are walking the streets now trying to go forward with wearing their heads back. Trying to stand up with their pants so big they're falling down.
You go ahead on the
preacher. They're trying to do things that they cannot do. We watch the athletes. We just went through basketball season and we all suffered from basketball withdrawal.
Yeah.
And we watched the Bulls and they played their games and we watched these teams and these young men, when they made a basket or when they knocked each other down, they'd run into each other with their chests or they beat their chests.
Mm-hmm.
And they'd call themselves men jumping up and down. But right after they would commit that act, they would get called for a foul, and you'd see them stuck their feet and crying. And they cried, and they cursed, and they screamed, and nobody could handle them because they got called for a foul.
All right.
That's a man child. It's not a man. And we're not raising men now. Our men are doing things that are all against us in nature as black men.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
We're forcing our women. Our women are the best women in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're fighting our women.
Amen.
And Gideon was hiding behind the wine press.
Yeah.
Pressing some wheat.
Mm-hmm.
And he's hiding it from the other tribe because the other tribes came over and just took everything.
Yes.
And
yes.
So where were the Israelites is in the cave. As many as 3,000, 4,000 were hiding in the caves away from their enemies.
Yes.
Because their enemies were like sand.
Mm-hmm.
There were so many of them.
Yes.
They had animals and people that were just like grains of sand. There were so many they couldn't withstand them.
Mm-hmm.
But they're hiding. Gideon is just bringing this little boy his family. His father's in there, and the Lord comes with him. The angel of the Lord comes.
Mm-hmm.
He's hiding so nobody sees him. And you know how to hide this. Let me make it plain to you. In your neighborhoods, you hide behind them gates.
Mm-hmm.
And you hide behind them double locks of your windows.
Yes.
Locked up from your sons and your daughters.
All right. All right. Come on now.
Some of you got
come
your refrigerators
on.
Locked up.
Yeah.
So we hide. Just don't look at Israel like they're doing something wrong.
Yeah.
I tell you how bad you hide. Remember when you get the good stuff, the TVs and stuff?
Uh-huh.
Cut up your boxes on the inside and sneak it outside.
Uh-huh.
On the garbage.
Yeah.
So won't nobody know you got a new TV.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Right.
You hide that stuff.
Right.
You know when you leave town, how you take your bags out in the middle of the night so everybody doesn't. This is what Gideon was doing. Now,
yes.
So don't look at him like he's so wrong, because we're doing the same thing against each other. As a black man, when you're standing on the corner waiting on the bus and you're walking down the street, the most sickening thing you can hear in your life is to hear a black woman hit a lot of them. But she's afraid.
That's right.
She don't know you from anybody else.
That's right.
Now you're used to white people doing that.
That's right.
But you're not used to black people doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Our black boys are being mistreated.
Yes.
And they're being mistreated sometimes by our black mothers who call them boys treasures.
Mm-hmm.
My baby. My honey. My sweet thing.
Yes.
They don't call them men of valor. They don't call them kings, as the Lord
says.
Yes.
They don't call him young God, but they call him young faith, precious son.
Yes.
Every now and then they may call him my angel.
Yes.
But then they call him my angel, he's the worst thing in the world. So we're mistreating them by not raising them in the fashion that they should be. Now when they come along and they get a wife, what are they acting like? They're acting like these basketball players, like men, children. And they're making more money than most people make in a lifetime.
Amen.
But they're acting like little boys. And when a little, or when a man acts like a little boy, it forces his wife to act like his mother. Now, if you don't believe it, look around the church and see how many men are in churches. And if it wasn't for the women, praise God. Somebody hear me now. If it wasn't for the women, the churches would not go on. But it's not the men's fault. I want you to understand that. See, women got a grandmother and a mother who keep them in line in the churches.
Yes.
If the mother don't do it, the grandmother don't do it. And if the grandfather don't do it, some aunt steps in and do it.
Yes.
But when a man runs away from his family, everybody else runs. The children don't have nobody else to go to school. So that boy don't have a father to take him to church, or the father wasn't in church in the first place. Turn around and blame this young boy who didn't know anything in the first place when they should have taught him. You loved him when you should have tapped him on the
floor.
You pushed him when you should have been putting a book in. Now let me tell you how you do in church.
Come on, preacher.
You take the young girl and you make her pray, you make her sing, you make her stand, you make her speak about. You make her pray at home. You take the little boy and you let him play outside.
Yes.
He plays outside, he goes to sleep in church.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
He don't have no church.
Yes.
He's in church, but ain't no church in him.
Yes.
And when he needs church in the best time of his life, he don't have it.
Yes.
He's got nothing within him to withhold him when the world gets him. And the world does not take it easy on our children.
Amen.
The world don't take it easy on our men.
Yes.
When he goes to the job, he don't have nothing to hold him. Because he's the last hire, the first fight. He don't understand it. He don't understand why he's late all the time.
Yes.
He don't understand why he can't take
care of him.
He don't understand what's going on in his life. Because nobody's sitting him down and telling him what's wrong with him.
All right.
And then he wakes up confused. And he starts drinking alcohol. Philippians 2:13, it says, for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of this place. Okay? So God's going to work his will in us if we just be still.
That's right.
If we just use that, those are the signs that he gives us. He gives us the book, the scripture to look for. And Gideon went to the scripture. That's the first thing he said. If God is so good, and I'm such a man of valor. Where is it in his word? Why are we doing this? He brought us out of this trouble. How can we end it now if I'm so much a man of valor? And the angel of the Lord told him, well, look, I'm going to be with you. And because you see the Lord face to face, you're not going to die. Says, but here's what you do. You got to do something. And what do you do? The man looks for validation in himself. And he don't have validation in himself because we're not giving him validation. We're not calling him a child of the king. We're not telling him who he is. And when he don't know who he is, how can he train his children who they should be? And how can his and his wife come together to find out who they are? Remember, now they're supposed to be one. And they can't, the two can't come to one because they fight separate personalities. And they wonder, and neither one knows who they are. See? Because, and I got this from a woman. Now, I ain't going to tell you what woman she acknowledges it if she wants to, but the first five books of the Old Testament is written about seven men. Abraham, Jacob, Joseph, Moses, and David. Ain't no women in there. The only woman in there is Eve, who was confused. Okay? So we can't go anywhere without our men. We can try to. We can have a season where we'll help guys. A little season where our women help. But we can't continue to raise our men to not be men.
Amen.
And to not do the things of men.
Amen.
Why is it we have young boys who have you got to pull them out the chair to get them to do something? All little right. Girls jump up.
Right.
And our little girls are valuable, but we don't present them as valuable.
Sure.
If you look at a child's eye, a little girl's eye, it's like little diamonds in an eye. Just little diamonds that the little eyes just shine all the time.
Yeah.
Her eyes stop shining when she's been hurt. When somebody takes that away from her.
Yes.
And we should be the protectors of our children.
Right. Yes.
But we can't protect our children because society, instead of putting us in straits,
put
our men are going to jail. We got more men in jail than we have on the street.
Amen.
And the rest of them in the street.
Right.
Then that ain't in the street, waving their hands.
Yes.
Amen. So they're not doing what they should be doing. I'm not being me.
Yes.
We can't continue to let them not be men.
Yes.
We got to mold of them and make them the way God says. That's the only way they're going to be there.
Yes.
We got to lift them up, uplift them, and lift them. Why don't we know this? And we still say, yeah, the civil rights movement, yeah, we got power, we did that. We are worse now than we've ever been.
That's right.
Than we've ever been.
Sure.
We got men who are dead and on their feet walking the street. That's why you're afraid. You don't know. You want to help them. You used to be able to give men jobs. When in the 50s, when I didn't have a job, I'd get some dust, soap powder. Y'all don't even know what that is. It had two black folks on it.
Yeah.
Dust, soap powder. And some, what do you call it, the sponges, and some rags. And I'd go wash down stores. Now, the Jews always gave us a way to make some money. Wasn't much, but he gave me a way to make some money. And I made more money that year than I ever made in my life. Because I was able to go and work. Now, you can't trust anybody in your house. You can't trust nobody around your car. What we're doing is it takes away the Lord told us to do it.
Amen.
The God of man offers himself to God. You can't offer somebody else. You can offer yourself. What you're trying to do is you go to church for yourself. You pray for yourself.
Yes.
But your son, they ain't praying for themselves.
Amen.
They ain't going to church for themselves.
Right.
And you ain't standing in yourself, in your house, saying, for God I live and for God I die. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And if you live in this house, you're going to church.
All right.
That's where it should be.
Amen.
But we got our young teenagers telling us what they ain't going to do.
That's right.
And they ain't going to do it because we have not been direct.
Yes.
We have promised them things and not done.
Yes.
We've told them, no, this is not going to happen in this house, but you let it happen anyway.
All right.
You promised, well, you got to get up Sunday morning.
Yes.
And then Sunday morning. He said, well, you can't get late, so I didn't wake you up. No.
That's right.
God's got to be in the household.
Yes.
God's got to be in his life.
Amen.
He can offer only himself, and you can't offer him. And he's got to be visible.
Mm-hmm.
His life is the content of his character.
Yes, yes.
He's got to be visible. The Lord sees all and knows all.
Right.
He can't hide what he do and say one thing here and do one thing over there.
Amen.
He can't be a deacon today and the hell raising the bar. Above board in front of his sons and his daughter and his wife and above all in front of God.
Amen.
Because the sum total of what you do in the dark is what you do. We've got to learn to do and to be. And he follows instruction. Now look, the Lord told Gideon, so now you go. Gideon built the altar. And the Lord said unto him, 25th verse, and it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bull, even the second bull of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father had, and cut down the grove that is by it, and build an altar unto the Lord of God upon the top of this rock, in the appointed place, and take the second bull up, and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove which thou hast cut down. Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants and did as the Lord had said unto him. Mm-hmm. And so it was because he feared his father's household and the men of the city that he could not do it by day, that he did it by night.
All right.
And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down and the robe was cut down that was by it. And the second bullet was offered upon the altar that was built. The man of God, though he may be afraid, will go. He'll go and follow the Lord's instructions.
Yes.
Now God meant us to do what he said.
Yes.
And he meant for our women to stand by us as we do it.
Yeah.
And we have to learn to do it. Now he don't mean for the woman to do it in place of the man.
Right.
Okay? But we're forcing the women to do it in place of the man.
Amen.
But when we act like men, like boys, you have to act like mothers. You have to do it in place of us. But he meant us to do it.
Yes.
And so
yes.
somehow we've got to get our boys on the right track. Now we talk about the young boys
yes.
because the old boys are almost gone.
Yes.
Sometimes
yes.
when the young boys do things, a father may see his son doing something and it may straighten him out.
Okay.
It may straighten him out. I joined church because my son wanted to join. Had no idea that I was going to be in church every day. He said, Dad, I want to join, but I'm afraid. I said, what do you mean? I want to walk down that aisle. He said, nah, but I'm afraid. I said, he said, will you come go with me? Yeah, come on, let's go. And I walked him down that aisle. When I get down there, now, I got to jump. Attacked by the Midianites again.